कैडेट्स गुड मॉर्निंग। सो स्टडी आई कंप्लीटेड टू थीरीज ऑफ मीन्स डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कैटलिस्ट लाइक होमोजेनियस कैटलिस्ट एंड हेटरोजेनियस कैटलिस्ट। फॉर होमोजेनियस कैटलिस्ट विच थ्योरी इज वैलिड? इंटरमीडिएट प्रोडक्ट फॉर्मेशन थ्योरी। एंड फॉर द हेटरोजेनियस कैटलिस्ट विच थ्योरी इज वैलिड? एडजॉर्प्शन थ्योरी। एडजॉर्प्शन थ्योरी इज द कंप्रिहेंसिव थ्योरी। In that theory, intermediate product formation theory is also included. So I hope that you have completed and got it also. Now today I am going to teach you important features of solid catalyst. So just try to understand. There are various features of solid catalyst. Just see, catalyst may be of solid in nature, gas in nature, or liquid in nature, because different types of catalyst example I have given you in different types of reactions. So here basically we are concentrating the features of solid catalyst. So solid catalyst basically have got two features. The first one is the activity. So what do you mean by the activity of the solid catalyst? Activity of solid catalyst is nothing but a capacity of catalyst to increase the rate of reaction by not making strong bond with the adsorbent and allow them to collide effectively. Try to understand what catalyst will do. The capacity of the catalyst to increase the rate of reaction. How it will increase the rate of reaction? By adsorbing reacting species on its surface loosely. If strongly it will adsorb, then they will not be free to effectively collide with each other. That is why it should adsorb loosely, so that the little bit they should free to collide with each other. So that is the meaning of activity. So activity is nothing but ability or capacity of catalyst to increase the rate of reaction by not making strong bond with the reacting molecules or reacting species which are adsorbed at their surface. Okay? And just see, they provide large surface area for the effective collision. Who is providing large surface area? As you know, the catalyst only will provide the large surface area. The second features of solid catalyst is selectivity. Selectivity, what is the meaning of selectivity? Ability of catalyst to direct a particular reaction in particular direction. Now try to understand. Reactant may be same, but if catalyst is different, so you will get the different types of product. Just see here. Three reaction I wrote here. Carbon monoxide plus hydrogen, catalyst is nickel. What is the product here? Methane. Carbon monoxide and hydrogen, what are the catalyst? Copper, zinc or Cr2O3. Product is methyl alcohol. Carbon monoxide and H2, here catalyst is copper. And now here what is there? Product is formaldehyde. So what I want to convey you, everything is means reacting species are same, but catalyst is different, hence product is different. Means catalyst has got ability to select its own product. Are you getting my point or not? So ability of catalyst to direct a particular reaction in a particular direction, that is ability of the or selectivity of the catalyst. Means one particular catalyst will select its own product. Means if I am the catalyst and if I am present in that particular reaction, then I will decide what will be mine product. Because you can see here, in all the three reactions, what is there? The reacting species is same. Only what is different? Catalyst is different. Hence, product is different. So we can write here, catalyst select their own product. Here we can write here. Here only I am writing. Catalyst, another point. Catalyst select its own product. that is the meaning of selectivity. Okay, dear cadet, this is fourth one is also one of the reaction which clearly support the selective nature of catalyst. Just see here, what is the reactant here? Ethyne. Okay, I am subjecting it for hydrogenation in presence of PT. If PT is the catalyst, then product will be ethane. But if PD and BaSO4 is there, then what would be the product? Product will be ethene. Now who has made the difference? Catalyst has made the difference. In this way, the features of solid catalyst is over. Now another one topic is there, that is safe selective catalyst and catalysis. Try to understand here, in safe selective catalyst, what is there? Now some catalyst have got pores in their structure, small holes, small pores, small cavities they have got on their structure. And now according to the size of their pores, what they will do? They will select the reacting species, and in their cavities or pore, those reacting species undergoes transformation, and after transformation they will form the product. So the reaction, we can write here, the reaction which depends on the pore size of catalyst. The reaction which depends on the pore size of catalyst, that is known as safe selective catalyst. Actually geolites are the best example of safe selective catalyst. So just see, you know what are the geolites? Geolites are the sodium, alumino, silicates. What are they? Sodium, alumino, silicates. Okay? You can write like that also. NaAlO2. Now here whole N, their number will be more. Now in their structure it is like that. Just see. AlO, Al, and here what is there? This side also there. So this is network. What kind of structure they form? Honeycomb like structure. So just see, if you have seen the honeycomb structure, then what is there? There are so many small pores or not? Just like the honeycomb spore, these geolites also form the small pores on their surface, and according to the pore size they will select the reacting species. Actually this is 3D network structure. So dear cadets, these geolites have got 3D network structure. In their 3D network structure only small pores and cavities are there. And then a reactant which have got the shape, you can write here also, the reactant which have got shape exactly like the size of pores. here you can write the reactant which have got shape exactly like the pore size of pore size of catalyst. Undergoes transformation inside the cavities. Inside the cavities and for product. Okay, this is there. Now one very important thing is there is one shape selective catalyst. What is the name of that shape selective catalyst? The name of that shape selective catalyst is ZSM5. What is that one? ZSM5. What is this one? This is 5. This is shape selective catalyst. And what is the important thing about this one? This shape selective catalyst convert alcohol into gasoline. Do you understand the meaning of gasoline? Gasoline means petrol. Okay, so just see, ZSM5 is shape selective catalyst. In their structure some small pores or cavities are there, and now these pores will absorb the alcohol, and inside its cavities they undergoes, just see here you can write, inside the pores of ZSM5 alcohol undergoes dehydration and dehydrogenation and convert into petrol. Okay, petrol means gasoline. So just remember its name. This ZSM5 is nothing but a shape selective catalyst, and it is responsible for the conversion of alcohol into gasoline or petrol. In this way, one more point is here. If you want to write, you can write the pore size of geolite varies from 260 picometer to 280 picometer to 740 picometer. 700 picometer means this is the size of pore. Means their pores or cavities size will varies from 260 picometer to 740 picometer. Now in the exam, if small notes comes regarding shape selective catalyst or ZSM5, so you are able to write, because each and every point I wrote here. ZSM5 is nothing but a shape selective catalyst which is responsible for the conversion of alcohol into petrol. In this way, this particular topic is also over. There is one word which often we come across, that is autocatalysis. Autocatalyst or autocatalysis. So just see, in the laboratory we are doing one titration. What kind of titration we are doing? We are doing actually redox titration, means reaction of KMnO4 with acidic KMnO4 with oxalic acid, or acidic potassium dichromate with Mohr salt. Okay, so just see, acidic KMnO4 means KMnO4 plus H2SO4, acidic potassium dichromate means K2Cr2O7 plus H2SO4. So try to understand, when we titrate acidic KMnO4 with oxalic acid or Mohr salt, that time what is there, we are not adding any indicators. Nevertheless, KMnO4 is producing color. Okay, so just see, try to understand, autocatalyst means there is no need to add the indicators from outside, from external agency. Substance which is formed during the course of reaction, that itself will act as a catalyst. Okay, are you getting my point or not? So just try to understand, note down next heading, that is autocatalyst or autocatalysis. So dear cadets, now term is autocatalyst. So as already I explained you, there is no addition of catalyst or indicator from outside. The product which is formed during the course of reaction, that will act as a catalyst itself. So just try to understand here. This is the reaction, potassium permanganate. What is the color of this one? Violet color. Okay. Initially what would be there? Just see, when product is not formed, its color, reaction mixture color will be violet only. But in due course of time, as the concentration of MnSO4 increases, its violet color fades away due to formation of MnSO4. As the concentration of MnSO4 increases, violet colors decolorize down. Now solution will become colorless. So just try to understand, here MnSO4 is autocatalyst, means this is itself acting as a catalyst. You have not added catalyst from outside, and such reaction, such phenomenon is known as autocatalysis. This reaction I taught you last year also. Okay, so here 5 atom of nascent oxygen is released. In this way, this term is also over. Now this term will be used in volumetric titration, and even in viva your external examiner may ask. That is why I clarify this one. This is there in your syllabus. Now so in this way, these two things I taught. Now you are in a position to understand the application of adsorption. Just try to understand, earlier I told that I will not teach you the applications of adsorption. Now your knowledge has become very broad in terms of adsorption. So just try to understand, next heading is adsorption, application of adsorption. So just see, what are the different application of adsorption? So just try to understand, what is the first application? First application of adsorption is in making the mask. So application of adsorption, the first application is in making mask. Just try to understand, see, wherever mining work is going on, coal mines, iron mines, bauxite mining, copper mining, what is there? Some harmful gases like carbon monoxide and methane. What are this one? These two are harmful gases. What is this one? These two are harmful gases. So they produce in that surrounding where mining work is going on. Then what is there? Miners means the person who are involved in this mining work. What is there? They will be affected. That is why their employer is providing them mask. In that mask, what is used? Mask. So in the mask, as a adsorbent, charcoal is used. What is the charcoal now here? Adsorbent. And now, what are these gases, harmful gases? Adsorbate. So on the surface of charcoal, these harmful gases will be adsorbed. And now miners will get the fresh air. Means in the air, these gases will be adsorbed. And the rest of the gases will not be adsorbed. That is why the person who are involved in the mining, they always wear mask. That is the first application. What is the second application? Second application is as dehumidifier. So just try to understand. Sometime what is there? The presence of water vapor in air, that is known as humidity. What is this one? The presence of water vapor in air, that is known as humidity. When humidity is more, just try to understand. Humidity is more means perspiration would be more from your body. Sweating will be more. So try to understand. Basically two substance. One is aluminium gel. Aluminium gel and silica gel. They are basically, aluminium gel and silica gel, they are acting as dehumidifier. Dehumidifier means they absorb the, here right, dehumidifier. They absorb water vapor present in the air. Water vapor present in the air. Okay. So just see, if these moisture is adsorbed, your surrounding will be free from moisture and you will feel cool. So this is the second application. Now what is the third application? Dear cadet, this is dehumidizer. Means here D-I-Z-E-R. Here also D-E-H-U-M-I-D-I-D-I-Z-E-R. So now spelling is correct. Now what are the other application of this one? The other application is third application. In dyeing clothes. Just try to understand. Third application is in dyeing cloth. So just try to understand. Sometime what is there? Your cloth is decolorized. Then you are giving this one to laundry for dyeing it. So how they dye? Just try to understand. In cloth, so many fibers are there. So many fibers are there or not? And if those fibers are colored, then only your cloth will produce different color as a whole. Am I correct or not? So just try to understand. There is a one term that is known as mordant. Mordant are the substance. What are they? Mordant are the substance which first fix in fibers. And these mordants only adsorb the different colors. So if your cloth is decolorized, first they should be dip in the mordant. As a mordant, alum is used. Alum, you might have heard or not? Sodium, potassium, alum. एलम K2SO4 Al2SO4 होल थ्राइस होल K2SO4 Al2SO4 होल थ्राइस डॉट 24 H2O ओके दिस इज एलम. सो एज ए मॉडर्न्ड फर्स्ट व्हाट इज यूज्ड मॉडर्न मींस एलम इज यूज्ड एंड वंस योर फाइबर्स इज डिप्ड विद दीज मॉडर्न सो दे विल एब्जॉर्ब पर्टिकुलर कलर इन विच योर क्लॉथ इज नाउ डिप्ड और वट एवर कलर क्लॉथ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव. सो बेसिकली एडजॉर्प्शन इज प्लेइंग हियर इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल इन डाइंग ऑफ द क्लॉथ ऑल्सो. ओके सो दिस इज देयर इन अनदर एप्लीकेशन इज रिमूविंग द फोर्थ वन इन रिमूविंग द कलरिंग मैटर फ्रॉम द सल्यूशन. In removing the coloring matter from the solution. In removing the coloring matter from the solution. Just try to understand. Understand the means utility of adsorption in this case. Already I taught you sugar has got the impurity of organic substance. Because of that only freshly prepared sugar is brown in color. What is their color? Brown color. Okay. When it is subjected to bone charcoal, means it should be passed through to bone charcoal. Then what is their charcoal that is adsorbent? It will adsorb the brown color of sugar and sugar will become now colorless. So same way juice, okay, syrup and some other fruit juices, syrup or some other things, solutions, if they are colored because of the presence of impurity, so they should be passed through the particular adsorbent. So those adsorbent will adsorb the impurities which are responsible for the production of different color. So try to understand here, adsorption is playing role in removing the coloring matter from the solution, as sugar, as in the syrup, as in the solutions, as in the fruit juice. So you can write this one also. Another application, that is the fifth application, is in heterogeneous catalysis. Just try to understand. I hope that you understood the meaning of heterogeneous catalysis. Just see, in heterogeneous catalysis, what is there? The physical state of catalyst and reacting species is different. The best example is N2 gas, Haber process, plus 3H2 gas. And here, what are the catalyst? Iron, this is solid. And molybdenum, this is catalytic promoter. They form NH3. What is the name of this process? Haber process. That is the commercial production of process which is responsible for the large scale production of ammonia gas. That is known as Haber process. So just try to understand here, iron is the catalyst. Remember here, this is iron is only catalyst. And what about MO? This is catalytic promoter. Catalytic promoter. So try to understand here, catalytic promoter increase the efficiency of catalyst, catalytic efficiency. So MO will increase the catalytic efficiency of iron. Now try to understand what is the use of adsorption here. Just see, on the surface of iron, these two gases, that is nitrogen and hydrogen, they will adsorb on their surface. Then only effective collision would be there. Otherwise, already you have written one point. Adsorption is playing very much important role in case of heterogeneous catalysis. because in heterogeneous catalysis, what is there? Basically, as a reactant, gaseous substance is used, and as a catalyst, solid substance is used. So, solid substance means catalyst, they will adsorb the gaseous substance. Otherwise, gaseous substance will run away here and there. And now, effective collision won't be there and product will not form. So, adsorption is playing very much important role in heterogeneous catalysis. Basically, in homogeneous catalysis, what is there? The physical state of reactant and the catalyst is same. So, much importance is not there. It doesn't mean that importance is not there. Importance is there. But in heterogeneous catalysis, adsorption is playing very important role. Okay. Another application is, just see, in salt analysis. Salt analysis. Just try to understand. In salt analysis, we have got anion and cation. You know, the cations are divided into groups. Zero group, first group, second group, third, fourth, fifth. Like that groups are there or not? Now, Na positive, then ZN2 positive, lead positive, then what is there? Ammonium positive. These are the cation. They are divided into groups. So, just see, in the third group, what is there? Third group, basically three cation is present. Fe3 positive, then Cr3 positive, and Nickel3 positive. Correct or not? Sorry. Aluminium3 positive. Al3 positive. Now, try to understand here. In the confirmatory test of aluminium, what we are using? We are using, there is a one test. What is the name of that one? Lake test. Lake test. Whether you did or not, I don't know, because I am not taking the practical classes. But for the confirmation of Al3 positive ion, there is a one test that is known as Lake test. In Lake test, what we are doing? We are using the blue litmus solution. What we are using? Blue litmus solution. And that blue litmus, see, what is the group reagent for third group? The group reagent for the third group is NH4OH in presence of NH4Cl. So, this aluminium will react this one and form aluminium hydroxide, Al3O positive. And on the surface of this one, what is there? Blue litmus solution is adsorbed on their surface. Adsorbed. Okay. So, you have added blue litmus. Now, it will be adsorbed on the surface of aluminium hydroxide. So, in entire solution, lake-like structure will emerge. Lake. Here and there, the small drops where entire blue color is getting adsorbed. That you can see. This is lake test. So, adsorption is playing very important role in salt analysis also. Dear cadets, adsorption is playing very important role in the production of vacuum. Sometime what is there? Air. If you want to create somewhere vacuum, then what should be there? Air first should be liquefied. So, for the liquefaction of air, there is one special apparatus, Dewar flask. In Dewar flask, what is there? First, air is liquefied. Liquefied. And this air will be adsorbed. Air will be liquefied and this air will be adsorbed on the surface of charcoal. Then what would be there? Vacuum will be generated. So, this is the one application. What is the next application of this one? In curing diseases. This is also playing important role. Just try to understand. See, diseases are basically spread due to attack of virus and bacteria. And we are taking different types of medicine to cure. Okay? So, just try to understand how these drugs or medicine work. Just try to understand. when we swallow, even if vaccination is there, so vaccine or medicine, first they digest and they go to the blood. And just see, in the blood only there poison are there. Those virus and bacteria, whatever harmful substances they produce, they are present in our blood only. So these medicines, they go to their surface and get adsorbed and they destroy them. So who is playing the role here? Adsorption is only playing the role, nah? Another application is, that is ninth one, in chromatography. What is there? In chromatography. Just try to understand. Last year only I taught you chromatography. In there are different kinds of chromatography, paper chromatography, column chromatography, thin layer chromatography. But in all types of chromatography, adsorption is only playing the role. See, especially in the column chromatography, what are there? Stationary phase, moving phase, two phases are there or not? So in stationary phase, what you are using? You are using the adsorbent like silica gel. You have used or not last year? And these adsorbent adsorb the different colors. That is why what is there? Different bands, color bands are formed. Correct or not? And subsequently they are removed by the eluent. Okay? Retention factor, everything you studied or not? So who is playing role here? Adsorption is only. The last one is in inert gases. Means you can say separation of inert gas. Inert gas, have you heard or not? Just see. Inert gas is helium, neon, argon, krypton, and xenon, and radon. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. These are different inert gases. And their rate of adsorption is different. Rate of adsorption is different in coconut charcoal. So since their rate of adsorption is different, so different inert gases can be separated. Correct or not? So in this way, these are the 10 application I taught. There are various application. Last year you studied the removal of hardness of water, resin method, different methods you have studied or not. What are they? There also adsorption is only playing the role. But if these 10 application you read, that is sufficient. Because nowadays, we can't predict that this particular question is important, this particular question is not important. The best way of study is touch each nook and corner of the syllabus, and it should be taught also. So from my side, I am trying hard. Rest onus is on you. Thank you. In this way, I have completed this one also. Next time, I will teach enzyme catalysis. Thank you.